the teaching profession, nobody had to sell me on the idea of going to a conference. And at my very first CMC South, somebody showed me that completed the square. Why the hell did nobody ever tell me this in high school? I mean, really, I was sold. But Jerry Nidenbach kept bugging me. And she kept saying, you have to go to Asilomar. I know you like Palm Springs. Palm Springs is great. And I would say, why? And she said, just trust me. So finally, in 2003, I did just that. I trusted her. I took a plane after work, got to Monterey. It didn't look like this. It was pitch black. I had the same experience as Steve. I got in a cab. No idea where I was going. But I was pretty sure that I was going to arrive at some sort of 1960s office park looking thing. Because it said conference center, and that's what conference centers look like. So you can imagine my absolute shock when I opened the door on the social hall. As much as I was in awe, I was also at home, because I realized that I had entered the world of Julia Morgan, and I knew Julia Morgan. Julia Morgan was actually born in 1872. She's a California girl, born right here in Northern California. And she came from a family of privilege. So in 1890, when she graduated school, it was completely reasonable that she went on to Cal Berkeley. She became the first woman to earn a degree in civil engineering. But while she was there, she discovered a passion for architecture. It was her mentor, Bernard Maybeck, who was himself a very proclaimed architect, who convinced her that she really should study at the École des Beaux-Arts in Paris. So she took herself off to Paris in 1896, despite the fact that the École had never admitted a woman into their architecture program. It took her three attempts to finally get them to admit her through a through an exam process. But she finished her certificate and became the first woman to get a certificate of architecture from the École des Beaux-Arts in 1902. My crib notes are dates. She returned to California, became the first woman licensed in the state of California, and around the same time, she met Phoebe. Phoebe, if you don't know Phoebe. Phoebe was an amazing socialite, but she was also an amazing social reformer. She was very involved in the women's suffragette movement and a huge believer in the work of the YWCA. She convinced her compatriots in the committee for the YWCA that they should have a conference, a standing conference here in the West Coast, like the Chautauqua conferences that were going on the East Coast, and that they should exist here in Monterey. And so in 1912, Phoebe hired Julia Morgan to design Asilomar. The very first building that was built was the Phoebe Hearst Social Hall, which now serves as our registration area. Soon after the chapel was built, it served as the only gathering space. It wasn't until 1928, Julia's last building here at Asilomar that we're now standing inside of, or sitting inside of for some of you, that they really had a full conference center. The stuck-up inn and the pirate's den were where the first workers actually stayed when they came here. The stuck-up inn were the young women who people thought were too stuck up, and the pirates were actually pirates, because the young men used to go and steal all the extra dessert, and therefore they were called pirates. If you came here as an honored guest, you stayed in the lodge. But if you came here as a participant, you stayed in a tent. It was a very high-class tent. It had a wooden floor. But no matter who you were, you dined communally in the dining hall. It was expanded greatly in 1960, but we still have the pleasure of eating there. 13 of the original historic buildings still exist on site. They're the largest collection in the state of her work. As of the 1950s, they're on the National Historic Register. Julia went on to build more than 700 buildings. She's got the most complete portfolio of work of any American architect. But even though she practiced until the age of 78, died at 85, it took the American Institute of Architects another 54 years before they finally made her, yet again, the first woman to win the gold medal from the American Institute of Architects in honor of her work. So when somebody says to you, what's so special about Asilomar? Absolutely, tell them it's this amazing setting. There's this community that you get to break bread with, and you get to talk to these amazing math educators. Please do tell them that at other conferences, the packed session is gonna be 50 things you can take straight back into your classroom. At Asilomar, it's Elizabeth Stage debating Dr. Wu on the merits of the 92 standards, three people deep out the door. But don't forget that one of the things that truly makes Asilomar special is the place that Julia Morgan built for us to learn and to lead together. Because she exceeded what her clients asked her to do in a way that we all should be grateful for. And if you don't know what Asilomar means, it is a mashup, and it means our refuge by the sea. So thank you, Julia Morgan, for this amazing place where we get to come and learn and lead together. Yeah.